Hello, thank you for watching this TBP video. We are at the Brainport Industries campus in Eindhoven and are meeting Stefan van Hout, who will tell us about Design for Excellence, also called DFX. Stefan, tell us, how long are you working for TBP?
I am working for TBP in the Netherlands since 2011. I've been the head of the test engineering department for several years now. Apart from the daily management, I am also involved in the development and innovation of our design for test activities, plus the further development of the test tooling within TBP.
You don't hear that very often. Can you tell us what DFX means and why is it so important for electronics development?
DFX stands for Design for Excellence, where the X can be filled in with every letter of the alphabet. DFT, Design for Testing, the DFM, Design for Manufacturing, DFR, Design for Reliability, DFL, Design for Logistics, etc. DFX is a very important part of the electronics design process. In order to make optimal use of our early supplier involvement services, it is necessary to start this process at the very beginning of the design. So the DFX process has to start from the moment there is an idea on block schematic level. In this phase of the development, the most important choices will be made for the design. Choosing the key components, functionality of the design, and in this early phase of the design, it is important that the EMS partner can already look and think along with the customer. And not so much about the functionality of the design, but about the package choice of the components, the testing possibilities, extra testing possibility built into the component, delivery times, component reliability, and obsolescence. The above decisions are very important because once the key components have been chosen, it is irreversible. Applying DFX delivers the most reliable product for the client, and this right first time. So by applying DFX, the client can receive a result obligation before production starts, which means the right first time percentage gives a view on the reliability of the boards and the delivery quality in PPM values.
Okay, clear. And what do you think is the correct order of the early supplier involvement services?
Early supplier involvement should start as early as possible in the design process, from the very beginning. In the different phases of the design process, it is important to carry out early supplier involvement as well. This in order to be able to respond quickly during each design phase and to quickly make any changes in manufacturability and testability, both on schematic and on layout level. So during an early supplier involvement project, no hardware has been produced yet. So the complete analysis is done in the virtual world. The advantage here is that changes can be made easy and at low cost. If a product is already finished and produced, it makes much more time and money to implement the changes.
Oh yes, so thinking ahead instead of thinking afterwards. And in which products and in which markets is electronics used?
Well, it is simply impossible to imagine life without electronics. Nowadays, it can be found in all aspects of our lives. You can make a distinction between consumer and industrial electronics. Consumer electronics are household appliances, mobile phones, Internet of Things applications, and much more. These consumer electronics are usually also produced in very high volumes. Industrial electronics can be found in all kinds of critical processes in the industry, such as the oil and gas, medical, defense, and aerospace. In general, these applications are produced in smaller volumes. At TBP, we focus on the production of industrial electronics, in particular smaller volumes and with a high-tech value.
I have one final question. Why is it convenient to test printed circuit boards?
Well, unfortunately, an EMS company cannot produce faultless, and therefore TBP as well. Our machines and people are not flawless. Also, the components we buy can contain errors. So in order to find the possible production errors, we need to test. During testing, it is not always possible to test all functions of certain components, and this will result in a list of components that will not or not completely fall under the test coverage. This list will be reported in a DFT report as a result of a DFT analysis, which result in a percentage slip-through. Slip-through is the percentage of components that are not or not completely testable with the available test tool. If necessary, the customer can adjust the electrical schematic or the components for a higher test coverage.
Great, Stefan. Thanks for your explanation. Do you have any questions for Stefan? Then post a reaction. Or do you want to see more of what we have in-house? Then become a subscriber to the TBP Electronics YouTube channel and follow our socials.